Hello, I am Dr. Anshu Gupta, Consultant Gastroenterology, Nayati Medicity, Mathura. Today on World Hepatitis Day, which is celebrated on every year on July 20th, I would like to give you some knowledge about hepatitis and the myths related to the hepatitis. World Hepatitis Day is celebrated for generally infective hepatitis, that is viral hepatitis. Viral hepatitis is generally caused by viruses, which are generally, we name it as hepatitis A, B, C, D and E. In this, first we will be dealing about hepatitis A and E, as because the mode of transmission of hepatitis A and E is fecal-oral. Fecal-oral means a person who is infected with hepatitis B, if he doesn't wash his hands properly, you come in contact with the food which is cooked, or infected with the hepatitis A and D, then you can acquire hepatitis A and D. The symptoms of hepatitis A and D are fever, generalized body weakness, jaundice, vomiting, pain abdomen. To differentiate between these two, we can't differentiate clinically. We have to get a blood test done. Generally, these two viruses present only in acute infection, and generally they resolve spontaneously in 4 to 6 weeks. Hepatitis E should be a little bit careful in a pregnant woman, because it can cause little bit fatal complications in pregnant females. To avoid this, we can always have a good hygienic food, hand hygiene and proper food hygiene to be maintained, so that we will be prevented by getting this disease. Next, dealing with hepatitis B and C, which is the most dangerous and threat to the society, as these can present as asymptomatic. These viruses can stay in your blood and liver for years together, and you will not be knowing it until unless you get your blood test done. Many a times a patient gets astonished as he finds that he has gone for blood donation. He feels he has got hepatitis B and C. The blood bank person will say your blood is unfit. Sometimes patient is admitted for any other surgery, hepatitis B, C is done, and they found it comes as positive. Sometimes a pregnant female coming for regular antenatal checkup finds that she has hepatitis B and C, and sometimes a patient presenting, these are asymptomatic conditions, and sometimes the symptoms are so high that patient can have jaundice, ascites, blood in vomiting, he can slip into coma and present in first time in coma, or even patient sometimes present with a malignancy, that is hepatocellular carcinoma, and incidentally will be found out to hepatitis B and C. Means he was infected from hepatitis B and C from so long that he did not notice it, and he went on to go to these complications. So hepatitis B and C can cause chronic liver disease and its complications, and hepatocellular carcinoma. To prevent hepatitis B, national immunization schedule has included all the child who are getting immunization schedule. It is hepatitis B is included in immunization schedule, but whoever not immunized with hepatitis B should definitely get a vaccine, which is available free of cost at in our government setups, and easily available at a cheaper rate at every other center, which is a simple 3 dose to be taken at 0, 1 and 6 months. And next, coming to how it is spread, hepatitis B and C. Hepatitis B, C spreads through unprotected sexual contact, through drug abusers who uses the single needle for every person uses to take the same drug. It can be transmitted from mother to fetus. It can comes to healthcare worker for needle stick injuries, and it can also come through if previously when the blood banks were not so accustomed to test hepatitis C. So that time hepatitis C had many years back spread through this blood, but nowadays the all blood bank is safe to, they screen these viruses and then only they give the blood for recipient. These are the types of modes of transmission. Coming to the treatment, hepatitis C is treatable. It's nowadays good medications are available depending upon the condition of the patient. From 12 months to 24 months we can treat hepatitis C, but we should remember that before the liver is damaged, we have to detect early so that we can treat early, so that the liver is not damaged. Once the liver is damaged and we treat hepatitis C, then hepatitis C or B, both, then it is difficult that we can't reverse the liver condition, but we can definitely prolong his life, and the complications of hepatitis C by treating, we can decrease it. So it is easily, generally a 2-drug regimen is available, means 2 drugs you have to take for 12 to 24 months. Next is hepatitis B. Hepatitis B also, after many a times, hepatitis B will not require treatment also, because body itself keeps the hepatitis B levels under check. So we have to many a times monitor his hepatitis B viral DNA levels and decide about the treatment of hepatitis B. If he requires treatment, then it is also a single tablet daily he has to take for long time. Generally, sometimes he might have to take lifetime also, so that his hepatitis virus is under control and his liver is not damaged. If we don't treat hepatitis B and C, then it can lead to chronic liver disease and hepatocellular carcinoma. So these two viruses are disastrous. Now coming to hepatitis D. Hepatitis D is alone can't infect a patient. It is only present in the patient who has hepatitis B infection also. So it is a co-infection. So it can't independently affect. So no need to worry much about hepatitis D, because a patient of hepatitis B only can get a hepatitis D. Now you're telling, how can we differentiate these hepatitis? We can't differentiate on clinically which hepatitis he has. We have to get only blood test done. Without the blood test, we will not able to differentiate the hepatitis, which type of hepatitis he is having. Now coming to some of the myths related to the hepatitis. Is jaundice only because of hepatitis? No. Jaundice is not because of only hepatitis. Jaundice is only a symptom of hepatitis. And second thing is, does hepatitis B and C parents can transmit their infection to the children? Yes, mother can transmit to the fetus. So for hepatitis B, we are available. We have immunoglobulin and vaccine which can give, if given to the baby during the delivery, just after the delivery, the chance of transmission is almost reduced to less than a 1%. So it is recommended that if a patient of hepatitis B is pregnant and should be under constant touch with a doctor, so that during the delivery time they can give a baby immediately within 24 hours those injections, so the baby can be protected from hepatitis B. Third is the questions most commonly arises is breastfeeding. Yes, we can give breastfeeding for hepatitis B and C patient can give their child breastfeeding. It is safe to give breastfeeding. Only the care we have to take is that the nipple should not have a crack, so that if it is bleeding from there, then the patient and the child mouth is also some abrasion, then it can transmit. Otherwise, it is very safe to take breast milk of the mother in hepatitis B and C patient. Finally, at last, I have to say, this year's slogan is find the missing millions. Means there are many millions of patients who don't know they have hepatitis still, that is B and C, because it can be asymptomatic. So generally, a patient should definitely, if his family history or somebody else is having, so he is definitely, if in touch of a doctor and somebody advises him to get a hepatitis B and C test, he should not be reluctant and he should get it done, so that he can be safe. And if he has not vaccinated for hepatitis B, please get vaccinated for hepatitis B. Thank you.